right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Steve Saviuk, the CEO of Valeo Pharma. And Steve, it's good to have you back.
Steve, good to be here.
So we're talking about you releasing your Q3 numbers. And, you know, on paper, they don't look as good as they did last year. But there are some things that people need to understand about what's going on this year. So tell us a little bit about the numbers.
Yes. Well, it's always difficult to compare one quarter to the next quarter in a growing company. There's ebbs and flows. But we were quite actually pleased with the third quarter. Maybe the numbers didn't reflect it as much as we did due to certain non-recurring charges that actually served to reduce revenue a bit and increase expenses. And we have to remember that last year in the third quarter, we had the launch of OnStrive, which had a big sell-in into the wholesale trade. So that again is kind of like a one-time thing that happens, one-time sell-in. And then there's a running kind of inventory run that's more, let's say, even after that. So these are the things that we have to take into consideration. But all in all, I would say pleased. You know, we had some share-based compensation due to some options we granted and warrants. Many of those to our employees to tide them over during this COVID time. Special recognition of those that had to work. You know, many people were able to stay home working for other companies. We had some people in the trenches that were taking orders from our customers, shipping our medication, our drugs out of the back. And I thought it was something that we should recognize that they went sort of above the call of duty in doing so. We have, in the third quarter, we had a number of positive events in terms of products that were approved by Health Canada. We launched Amitop in the third quarter, which is a topical anesthetic. Unfortunately, it was launched virtually in the last week. It contributed nothing to sales, but Amitop's been launched at the end. Yondelis in early August, which is the beginning of our fourth quarter. And both of those are contributing already to revenues. They represent in total about 13% of our revenues to date in the quarter. And we still have the launch of our U.S. product, sodium ethacrynate, which again was delayed in part through due to some COVID / holidays in Italy where the product's made. That's actually being launched next week in the U.S. So that's very excited about that. And of course, Hesperco, which is our flavonoid that we have high expectations for, that also will be launched in the coming weeks. So we're pretty excited about Q4. Q4 looks like it's going to turn out to be a pretty good quarter for us. Going into next year, we'll be going in with a lot of strength. And again, our objective is still break even in the month of October on an EBITDA basis. We're pretty excited about what the future holds. I think next year should be a pretty good year for us.
Yeah, it sounds like the way you're describing it is this is sort of, as you mentioned, a blip, but you feel the outlook for the company is still strong. Is that accurate?
Yes, that's correct. Yeah, as I said, sometimes you have these, especially as revenue is growing, these certain one-time charges or hits that you're forced to take. And it could even be a sale of some products that instead of happening at the end of July, they happen beginning of August. So there's a slight shift. Unfortunately, there's a quarter end in the middle, and then you miss it in one quarter and you catch it in the next. So I think that's to be expected in a company that's growing and that's our size. And these blips should be, although they'll continue to happen, I'm sure going down, they'll be less meaningful as our overall revenue base continues to grow.
You did hit a few milestones in that third quarter. You raised quite a bit of money as well. You were on the OTCQB. There's a lot of things that really went positive in the third quarter.
As far as the company, we're now well-funded, good working capital position, $7 million, $6.9 million financing, a bought deal through Stifel and a number of other underwriters in Canada. So we're very happy about that. We did start trading or quoted in the OTCQB. We're still waiting for something known as a DTC, which will improve the accessibility of the shares in the U.S. A lot of things happening, working very hard. The team is back as of September 1st. Any furloughed or sort of reduced hour employees are all back full time. We expect a busy fall and, hopefully we don't get impacted by the virus that seems to be spreading in Montreal, but we've taken measures to prepare for it. And, you know, this is our second time around, so we're going to we'll be even better than the first time around.
Absolutely. Steve, thanks so much. Great to catch up with you, and I look forward to talking again soon.
Thank you very much,
Steve. All right, Steve Saviuk, the CEO of Valeo Pharma.